In today's video, we will upgrade these soldered 16 gigs of RAM chips to 32 gigs capacity in the A1990 MacBook Pro 15-inch 2018. This 15-inch Retina MacBook Pro was sent to us for upgrade by Delaska Sonas Productions, a professional event management company that provides services from event conceptualization, creative 3D design to event consultation. With their vast industry experience, they are committed to accelerate ideas to make your event one of a kind and success. Their Mac that we have today is using the 2.6 GHz 6-core Intel Core i7 of the 8th generation Coffee Lake processors. Since this is the base model, it has 16 gigs of RAM by default and it is not easily upgradable to 32 gigs by the end user later as it was soldered to the logic board. We've covered the 3 digits of the serial number here to prevent others from stealing it, but yeah, we know some of you will still think this is a fake video. Anyway, we also have acquired the 64 gig RAM chips for the 16-inch 2019 and we will perform the 64 gigs upgrade in a future release, so make sure you already hit the subscribe button to not miss out the video. Before we disassemble the whole Mac and upgrade the logic board, we will be performing the initial QC to the whole MacBook hardware from keyboard, microphone, USB-C ports, battery and all other related hardwares by fitting our QC form template. We have upgraded hundreds of soldered RAM to our client's MacBook Pro and this is the method that we think is the best way to prevent and control damage to the logic board. We have uploaded the QC form template to the video description below. After the MacBook passed the initial QC stage, we can begin to disassemble the whole Mac to get access to the soldered RAM on the logic board. We have safely removed the logic board from the chassis, so the RAM chips on the top side were soldered underneath this black sticker cover, and if we flip the board to the bottom side, you will find another black sticker of the same size. Removing the cover with a knife and alcohol will expose 8 pieces of RAM chips on the bottom side with a capacity of 1 GB per chip. Turn it around to the top side and removing this one will expose another 8 RAM chips also with 1 GB capacity per chip, and the sum of RAM chips on the top and bottom sides makes a total of 16 RAM chips and hence making up the 16 GB capacity that we saw in the system report. So the mathematics is fairly simple now, right? In order to upgrade it to 32 gigs of RAM capacity simply means we need to replace all these 1 GB chips with 2 GB capacity, so the 16 chips times by 2 GB is equivalent to 32 gigs of total RAM. Now, since we are paranoid of getting these plastic stickers melt because of heat, we will remove all of them starting with the T2 plastic cover, GPU VRAM, battery inductor, Toshiba SSD NAND, right Thunderbolt, Toshiba NANDs again, left Thunderbolt, and finally Wi-Fi antennas. Flip to the bottom side and remove the heatsink screw to detach the whole heatsink, and don't forget to also remove the LCD flex cable. Remove the heatsink, flip to the top side, and we will switch the view to the microscope. As you can see at the chip's marking, it is clearly engraved with D9VPP and also the M for Micron logo. Start to create rectangle lines by scratching lightly around the RAM chip's perimeter, as these lines will assist positioning of the new chips later on. So here's the first one, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now switch to the bottom side and repeat the same steps starting from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8 chips. Well, I'm starting to sound like a morning stretching program, right? I will let the screen do the next counting for you. So now it's ready for RAM chips removal. Also, don't forget to remove the GPU cover if you doubt the heat. Carefully place the logic board on the IR heater glass. In this case, we use the BGA rework station, Jovi RE8500. Once you have aligned the laser with the center of the target, place the thermocouple to the RAM local area and start to preheat the main logic board with the bottom heater profile. We're targeting the bottom heater to reach around 140 to 150 Celsius, and once it has reached the target temperature, pause the BGA profile and the temperature should maintain as it is. Next, use the quick hot air with the maximum air and heat configuration as the top heater, and of course in this case the heat is controlled by adjusting distance from the target. As you heat the RAM chips from the top, you can see that it seems easy to take them off because the bottom preheater already adds 70% of the heat required to reach liquidus temperature for the lead-free solder. So we're gonna gently hold the RAM chip, not pulling it off yet, while moving the quick hot air to the chip circumference back and forth until you can move the chip and pull it off. Once you have removed all the RAM chips on the top side, right, slowly blow the air compressor from a distance to cool the whole logic board. Once it has cooled down, flip the board to the other side and start the bottom IR profile again until the board temperature reaches 140 to 150 Celsius, and finally remove the RAM chips using the same method again. So RAM on both sides have been safely removed. Now switch to the microscope view and we're gonna make a quick visual inspection to see if we knocked off anything. Okay, yeah, we did over here. It's a capacitor, so we're gonna quickly fix it now. So right now we're at the top side and we will add flux to all of the pads, as we will run the surface with leaded solder wire for easier wicking process later. Next, we can begin wicking the lead-free solder off on the first one.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
And clean the whole mess with Q-tip and 99% isopropyl alcohol. Next, flip it to the bottom side and repeat the same steps to all 8 RAM footprints. After both sides have been thoroughly cleaned, the logic board is now ready for the new RAM chips. These are the 32GB RAM chips that we have in stock, and each chip has 78 pre-balled solder balls. Under the microscope, you can see that it fits perfectly with the rectangle lines that we scratched before. So this is what you're waiting for. The serial number for the RAM chip is H5ANAG8NAMRUHC, a DDR4 RAM chip produced by SK Hynix. Next, we will apply solder flux to all of the 8 RAM footprints on the top side of the logic board and carefully align the 32GB chip into the rectangles we created before for this footprint number 1,
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Make sure you already cross-check each of the RAM chip's orientation by referring to the board view. If you haven't used this board view software yet, check out Paul Daniel's FlexBV. So the RAM chips have been decently arranged on the top side. Let's go to the BGA rework station to solder them all. As usual, gently put the board on the IR heater glass, then the thermocouples are placed outside the RAM guard and run the same bottom heater profile as before. After the thermocouple temperature on the logic board reaches 150 degrees Celsius, turn on the upper quick hot air and blow it all to the RAM chips in a circular motion. Ooh, you can clearly see the RAM chips are like sitting down on its place. Next, slowly blow the air compressor to remove all the heat and take the logic board off the heater. So the RAM chips on the top side looks pretty good. Next, flip to the bottom side. Repeat the same steps again, beginning with flux application to footprint number 1,
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
And followed by RAM chips placement on 1,
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
And check if all RAM chips have been properly aligned with the correct orientation and bring it to the IR heater again. So everything went really well and all of the RAM chips were successfully soldered to both sides. Next, we will head to the BCH area and find the RAM configuration strap. Open the schematics and find the RAM configuration. It is usually stated on the bill of material page, and sometimes they will give you a table of truth. So according to the schematic diagram, for 32GB Hynix RAM, you need to pull down L to all of the RAM CFG0, RAM CFG1, RAM CFG2, 3 and 4 pins by stuffing all pull-down resistors to their respective positions. The pull-down resistors can be found on page 15. So if we're looking at the board, we need to stuff the missing resistors R1530 and R1532. If you're not sure how to read the configuration, you can click on this video we've made explaining the working principle of the RAM straps. Next, we will partially reassemble the whole Mac just for the final QC test to make sure all hardwares are working and nothing were damaged during the upgrade process. Only the necessary screws will be installed, and please note this is not the final delivery condition. Now, moment of the truth, we will plug in the charger, open the lid and see if it's turning on.
Yeah, boy.
We will speed this up to the desktop. So we're gonna open about this Mac, and yes, it has 32GB of RAM now. Open the system report, and the memory tab also shows 16GB plus 16GB. So we're pretty much done here. This Mac will be passed to the QC technicians to perform final QC check before fully reassembling the whole Mac and releasing it to the client. Every single hardware should be checked again, and this time we will complete the right column on the QC form. So it seems everything works just fine. So that's it. This is the before and after the RAM upgrade process. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and make sure to subscribe and thumbs up the video if you like it. And see you again at iBof RCC channel, reverse engineering at its best. Have a nice day and thanks for watching.